Here are the instructions for running the snack shop. Don't worry, there's a lot of them, but it's not that difficult.
Okay, people, I'm ready to take your orders.
All you have to do is fill all the orders as they come in.
You know,
bread,
lettuce. I really like calculus.
Meat.
No, you don't. No, I do. I love going to that class. Everybody does. Mr. Harris is like the best looking teacher in the whole year.
Orders ready.
Whoa. I didn't know Mr. Harris was teaching here. Maybe I can transfer to his class.
Blizzard type snow.
Apple. To make a cookie, you just grab some cookie dough and put it in the oven.
Food's ready!
And this is basically all there is to snack shop duty. Put everything that's on the order on the plate. Pretzels, chocolate bar, and water.
That's not quite right.
It's not? I thought it was perfect. Okay, let me try it again. Cheese, tomatoes, and meat.
Order's ready.
Oh, I thought I had it correct, but apparently I didn't. Okay, so toasted bagel with meat, cheese, lettuce, meat. Orange chips, chocolate bar, and water.
Order up!
If you have toasted bagel or toasted bread, what you have to do is put them in the toaster oven. Not the toaster oven, just the toaster. It's not an oven.
Food's ready!
Alright.
There. All done.
Alright.
Whoa!
Yeah, what's this? Apparently, Nancy got some sort of key.
Wonder what this is to.
I know where the key leads to. The key leads to an area outside. It leads down here to the basement. What's inside the basement, I wonder? We have a strange sort of puzzle that you won't solve until the end of the game. Science Can Be Fun by Dr. Detroit. Various books. And a book about the United States of America. Okay! Is there anything else here? We have this, which is another puzzle you won't solve until the very end of the game. Or not the very end of the game, but near the end of the game. It's a 4-token puzzle. You need to get 4 golden tokens and put them into those various holes you saw on the wall. Alright, what I'm going to do now is follow through on the Madeline Moore plotline. If you remember in Mel's room, we have the cross-stitch pattern that talks about much, followed by more. That is your clue to look for more on the library catalog. Okay, story of 4 in the special collections. The special collections, right here.
Looks like I need a key.
Now, who has a key? Well, the assistant librarian would have a key, and the assistant librarian is Corine Myers. So let's go see Corine. Oh, hey! I found the lost and found. It is lost no more, for I have found it. And now we're going to see Corine. Hi, Mr. Mingles.
Hi. Hey, how come I couldn't find anything about you online, like on your page?
Oh, your page? I guess you must be talking about Stalker Book.
Is that a big deal?
Well, yeah. I mean, anyone under the age of like 30 who doesn't have something up on your page either A, has been living on Mars, or B, is seriously weird. And since it doesn't look like either of those applies to you, what gives?
I took my page down because, for personal reasons.
Yeah.
Well, do you have a boyfriend?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who is he? Where does he live? Come on, you can tell me stuff. I'm your roommate.
I'm sorry, but I'd rather not talk about him right now, okay?
Yeah, okay, whatever. So what do you want to talk about?
We want to ask her about the Special Collections Cabinet.
Do you know where I can get the key that opens the Special Collections Cabinet in the library?
You can get it from me. How bad do you want it?
Uh-oh.
Kind of bad. There's a book in the collection I'd really like to look at.
Okay, here's the deal. I'll give you the key to the cabinet if you can finish these orthographic views for me.
How do I do that?
Just figure out which views go with which object. Each object has a front, top, and side view. Those are examples in case you need them.
I can do that.
Bring them back when you're done.
Okay, so just like Izzy, Corine wants us to do her homework for her.
Anything else?
Let's get going on the homework first.
I've bugged you enough. See ya.
Suit yourself.
So this is how orthographic projection works. This is what the object looks like from the top. This is what it looks like from the front, or the left. And this is what it looks like from the side, or the right. So you just need to figure out which thing goes with which thing. Alright, so from the side, that's what this is going to look like. From the front, it's going to look like that. And from the top, it's going to look like that. Alright, that was easy enough. So basically you have to do that for all four of these orthographic views. I'm thinking this one, is that the top? No, this is that from the front. So I believe this is what it would look like from the side. Right? And from the top. No, wait. This is what it looks like from the top, and this is what it looks like from the side. Yeah, okay, that's it. Let me see. Which ones are these? Let me see. From the top, this one would look like a giant T. And from the side, it would also look sort of like a T. And from the front, it looks something like this. Alright, let's hope my answers are correct. This is the top. The side looks like an L. Here we've got a backwards L shape, you can see on the side. Which means this has to be the front. Right?
You finished those ortho views for me?
There you go.
Looks great. Thanks.
All right.
Here's the key to the cabinet. Whatever
awesome.
Books you take out, be sure to put them back when you're done. They're too old and fragile to carry around.
I will.
And leave the key in the lock. I'll grab it later.
Okay.
Anything else?
Okay, so I'm going to talk to Corine and finish the Book of Four subplot in the next video. After that, I'll get back to the taking pictures of everybody for Rachel's project plotline.